Dunwall is changing fast. 6 months ago, Draper's Ward was where Dunwall's rich and well-born strolled and shopped and tried to be seen. The plague burned through it in days. Today it's a battleground where two street gangs fight over the spoils. The Hatters and Lizzie's gang, the Dead Eels. Lizzie Stride was the boss until Edgar Wakefield betrayed her and took her place. And the riverboat. It's the kind of thing that happens every day in Dunwall. I don't judge him. I've done worse myself. But I need that boat. Edgar Wakefield and I have business.
Used to run off a water wheel before the canal went dry. It started up again recently, and whatever the Hatters did to get it working has enraged the Dead Eels. They're fighting in the streets.
Draper's Ward ain't yours! I got here first!
Bring out the geezer!
We've been here 8 years! We ain't leaving!
When's your old man coming out to fight?
We've been making something for you, little eels!
What's the matter? Too much knitting to do?
Crawl back to the river! You ain't a real gang! You're just a bunch of mudlarks!
Come on and fight! Or are you too busy making dresses?
Somebody get on the
river!
Come and get me, or won't your mommy let you?
You guys take orders from Trimble now, is that it? A nurse? You gonna teat on him?
Hatters, now and forever!
I'll cut you up like a slaughterhouse whale, you hear me?
Are you missing something, little eels?
I got a little something for you. Might burn a little, though.
Drive him back into the river!
Draper's Ward is our place now!
Come on,
let's get this river tonight!
Cry for mercy, piss puck!
Thank you.
I admit, I'm stymied. I thought dragging it up out of the mud was the hard part, but I have no idea how to open it.
Hammers?
Really? Look at that thing. You think hammers will break it open?
Explosives.
Sure. The sound brings everyone running. Then we gotta share. And what if it calls some eels, huh?
There must be a way. Think what could be in there.
You know what would be funny? If it wasn't locked.
What? Of course it's locked. Look at it.
You mean you haven't even tried it?
What do you think I am? Stupid?
Let me go. You won, all right?
Say it! Dead eels eat shit and like it. Say it and I'll let you live.
Wait, wait! Okay. Hatters eat shit and like it!
Those were your last words.
I thought I was finished. They'll never believe who saved me.
Welcome to the Draper's Ward Salvage and Resale, or the Black Market if you'd prefer. It's Dowd, right? Recognized your face from the posters. Not that I'd ever say anything to anyone, believe me. I'd be happy to have you for a customer.
What are you selling?
The best of Draper's Ward, all for sale. A sweet lady named Abigail left a little something for you. How did she know you were coming here? I have no idea. It's in my safe. Please, take it away. I've had nightmares since it arrived here. Say, would you consider doing a job for me? There's a man whose debt to me is well past due.
I'm not a bill collector.
I don't want the money. I want his head. I'd pay you well. And you can use the money to buy things from me.
I'll do it.
Huh. Thank you. Skinflint is a chain smoker. He likes to light up in the old canal tunnel and play Nancy for coin. I'd start there. Make an example of him.
Got it. Now let me see what you've got.
Please, take your pick.
Looks at him, like he doesn't even understand what's happening. Hilarious.
I can't believe Lizzie held us back all these years. This is living.
Oh,
with her?
Delilah, are you with her? No, but you don't have any roses.
What can you tell me about Delilah?
I used to make clothing for the Caldwins, you see. I adored them, especially young, precocious Emily. She was such a delight. Did you ever meet the Empress? She was so special. And I was able to count her among my friends. I had a lock of hair from young Emily, a keepsake given to me by the family when my hands grew too stiff and clumsy to work the needle. I have treasured it so.
And Delilah?
She visited me here. Such a surprise to see her, all grown up, so serious. Did you know she was once a playmate of Jessamine's? Before she was Empress, when they were both little. I thought it was a cordial visit at first, but it turned frightening.
What happened?
She made things come out of the shadows, long and grasping. I can still feel the cold on my neck. I sound mad, don't I? Perhaps I am. She questioned me and left me propped in the corner like a bolt of cloth. I couldn't move for 3 nights while she made the horrid markings you see now. Then she stole my only keepsake, my lock of hair from dear, sweet Emily. Ah, Emily, where are you? Damn that Corvo, and damn Delilah. Emily, she was such a sweet girl. I think Delilah may be insane. Here, leave me alone. Probably because Mortimer Hat used to respect my work in better days.
Lizzie enjoyed it more.
Yeah, even Lizzie never drowned victims in a sack. I can still see him squirming for air.
Yeah, how's he gonna top that? Who would have thought? Maggot Montaigne on a boat in Dunwall. A long way from Karnaca.
Wakefield is on board the Undine. He's put all of the Eels on alert since Lizzie's rumored to have escaped from Coldridge. He's expecting her. You will undoubtedly be a surprise to him.
There's the boat. Wakefield's probably keeping himself below decks. Whatever I do to him, it will be a mercy compared to what Lizzie has in mind.
I can't believe we're missing the boil party. Luxury. Sitting next to the river. Or canal, I guess.
Eels.
Just waiting to be taken.
All those prancing nobles in their fancy masks. Strip them of their jewels and set them on fire. Finest time in the world.
Drown them. Drowning's worse.
Set on fire's worse.
Drowned is worse.
You ever see a man set on fire? What does he do? He jumps in the water.
Very funny.
I hear Lord Shaw is making his way to the party by boat, with only 2 bodyguards.
What? How do you hear things like that?
I have some connections.
What the?
Wakefield sealed himself in the cargo hold of the Undine. Smuggling ships like this one often have a hatch underneath for dumping contraband if they get caught. Perhaps the Undine is no different.
Two butchers came here looking for work, crying about their warehouse.
What'd you tell them?
Laughed in their faces. Everyone knows they're scum. Besides, they couldn't stop talking about killing Dowd. And that's an enemy we don't need.
You ever get that creepy feeling of being watched? I've had that a bunch lately.
Funny you ask that. I had this feeling of eyes on me. I looked up on the roof of that building over there and...
There was a lady up there, right? I seen her too. Just staring. Then she was...
gone. In a wink. Yeah. We've seen the same thing.
Should we tell the others about it?
No. The others might think we're seeing things. First sign of the plague from what I hear.
This is the second time now. I see something, or someone, out of the corner of my eye. But when I turn, they're gone. Someone is watching us.
This is the Dowd I remember. Corvo left his mark on Coldridge, but they won't soon forget you either. What a relief. Life has been remarkably grim in Dunwall lately. This business with the Eels might call for a little more diplomacy. But in the long view, a smoking ruin makes as good a monument as any.
Dowd, what brings you here?
Lizzie Stride owes me a favor.
I'm sorry to hear that. You see, the Watch picked her up. I'm trying to hold things together while she's in Coldridge. I'm awfully busy at the moment.
I won't take too much of your time, but there's the matter of that favor.
Yeah? What exactly does she owe you for?
First, for getting her out of Coldridge. Second, for what's about to happen right now. Time to signal Lizzie.
Lizzie Stride is assuming control of the dead eels now. She's ordered them to give you safe passage.
Your friend Edgar Wakefield set me up to be taken by the City Watch, and you followed him. Took his orders. But you know what? I forgive you. All of you. I'm filled with love. But the following people each owe me a finger. Logan, Douglas, Bang Bang, Ferris, Pigface, the Bakers, and Annabelle.
Shit.
Two from you, Annabelle. Have a good night.
That piece of garbage, Edgar. I'm still living with his incompetence. He let the Hatters cripple the Undine.
The ship seems fine to me.
They took the engine coil. We're dead in the water.
What is it? Can we make a new one?
They don't make them anymore, not for an engine like the Undine's. We'll have to get it back.
The geezer still leads the header gang, right? I'll pay him a visit.
It won't be that easy. There's a snag.
Always is. What's this one?
The geezer's about 100 years old by now. He's got it rigged so that if he dies, the whole place gets gassed. So they're real careful around him. Got him a nurse and everything. Maybe you can cut a deal for that engine coil. Turn on the charm. One of the Hatters gave me their door password in exchange for keeping the rest of his fingers. It's whalebone. I never got to use it on account of the gas. And being in jail.
Just be ready to move when I get back.
I knew I could rely on you. I'll even forgive you for not making him suffer more.
Just get me upriver.
I'm not saying don't kill the geezer. Just don't be stupid about it. Engine coils are hard to find now. Most of them were scavenged for scrap when the blockade started. Who is your second? Billy? Benny? How'd that turn out? Without that engine coil, we're stuck here.
Ain't real. What'd I see Dowd do then?
Just because he can do strange things doesn't mean there's an invisible man watching us. I'll ask him how he does it.
Are you crazy? Don't you dare. We're not going about this right. We kill them one at a time, maybe they kill one of us. We're not making any headway.
What would you suggest?
Find one Hatter, cut the skin off him. Leave him for the rest to find. The acid flasks are brilliant. We should have had them years ago.
Funny. Point a gun at a skimmer and he gets all puffed up sometimes. Threaten him with acid and he'll cry like a baby.
There's just something about your skin melting off that's more intimidating. Looks like the end for you, fancy boy.
2-on-1, huh? If I had a blade, I'd gut both of you in a heartbeat.
Well, you don't. And we do.
Kill him, Sammy.
Calm down, boy. You gotta learn to savor the kill.
Shit! That's what happens when you tangle with a dead eel.
Just a few.
And get caught out when the dead eels come across the canal? No thanks. Every man...
Hatter pride. I'm touched.
What's the password?
Whalebone.
Come in, Hatter.
Sir, the Hatters are using the textile machines to make shrouds for the plague dead.
Now we know why they took the engine coil.
The man who runs the Hatters is more cunning than he looks. He can flood this place with a toxic gas. In time, it'll eat through our air filters. You may have to make a deal.
Who just went through here?
The Empress did. She had Corvo Otano with her. They weren't wearing no clothes.
Keep your hat on. I was just asking.
Just because you're in charge of the gate, it don't mean the rest of us are idiots.
Yeah? Well, since you're such a genius, it ought to be real easy to see who it was. So go check it out.
Fine. I don't know why you're worried about nothing.
Didn't think I'd ever see you again. After you helped us escape the slaughterhouse, I got a job here running the looms. They got us working around the clock, making shrouds for all of the plague victims. Kinda makes me sick. But they have to come from somewhere, I guess.
How do I get into the engine room?
It's down in the basement. But you can't get in without the combination.
And where would I find that?
Nurse Trimble. He takes care of the geezer. But I'd bet my broom handle that's only half the story. See, the geezer's supposed to be the boss, but Trimble never lets anyone near him. Claims it's for his health. I'm sure the geezer knows the combination too, except fat chance talking to him alone. Only time Nurse Trimble leaves is to check the lab equipment he's got upstairs.
Thanks for the help.
The only other person I've seen go into the engine room is the mechanic. But he went into the sewers and hasn't come back since. I'm going home. I hope I still have a job after you do whatever you came to do. Maybe you can find a way to talk to the geezer alone. Good luck, Doubt.
Wakefield's miscalculated badly. I predicted this would happen, of course. A man like Wakefield knows which end of a knife is for stabbing, but not much else. What's that? Oh, stop complaining, old man. I'm giving you a legacy. What were the Hatters before I arrived? I'll tell you. A shadow of their former selves. The butt of numerous jokes, in fact. Why did the Hatter piss in his own hat? What did the Hatter do with his last bullet? And so on. The answers aren't worth repeating. Leadership. That's what was missing. What with the embarrassing defeat at the hands of the Bottle Street Boys, of all things. There now. You mustn't become agitated. You'll inflame your arteries, which will only cause you unneeded agony. I can ease the pain, but only if you promise to behave yourself. No? Ah, that reminds me. I must see Jerome about getting more oxrush. I'm fresh out.
My name's Dowd. I'm looking for Lizzie Stride's missing engine coil. I'm giving you a chance to make a deal.
Is it worth all this to me to hang on about?
Yes, sir. Very reasonable offer. Geezer here says you're in luck. We only need that engine coil because someone shut off the flow that turns our water wheel. I sent men into the sewers to restore the flow, and not one of them came back. But what stopped them won't be a problem for the famous Dowd, will it? When the water flows, I'll give you the engine coil. Here's the key to the sewer entrance. And it's a pleasure to do business with you, Mr. Dowd. The Hatters will behave themselves, as long as you keep your end of the bargain, Dowd. I lost a man named Pete down there. Keep an eye out. The Eels could be on watch in there. Those sewers date back to well before the Caldwin Dynasty. No telling what's in there. I'm sure the great Dowd isn't afraid of what's down there.
No. I can't.
Please don't disturb him. Our chief needs his rest.
If you...
Dowd, I have Mr. Hat on very strict bed rest. I'll have to ask you to leave him alone. Please. The treatment is at a very delicate phase. Any disruption could kill him. Keep away from him, or I'll have you removed by force. Last warning.
This guy never made it back. Wonder if he's still down there.
You should get where you're going, little man.
you supposed to be scary?
How did it pass me by? All the others down with the sickness.
Like the golden cat.
She caught that hatter easy enough.
That fool. What if Dowd comes this way? He won't fall for a pretty face and a few tears.
Then so much for our little sister. But we'll make sure the job is done. Ritual is all said and done.
Why?
Don't be dense. She's afraid of us. When the change comes, she'll only want the weaker sisters nearby.
That makes no sense. Power flows from Delilah. Without her, we'd be reduced to dancing under the moon, parlor tricks. You must be wrong.
Why else would she put us here, right in his path? I wish he'd hurry up and come already. knows you're coming, cutting a bloody path through the city in search of her. Your nastiest work in years. She's afraid of you. But Delilah's a brilliant woman. Her coven is rising, with her as the night star to guide them. And once she's hatched her new schemes, she'll have a different kind of power. An empire instead of a coven. I wish you luck. I don't decide who wins and whose body gets tossed in the river to rot. But I do enjoy watching.
My little boy. He's not well, and I fell down here. I hurt my leg. Hello? You're not a weeper, are you? I think I can walk if you'll just help me up.
Whoever.
I almost had you downed. You could have had an easy death.
Tell me what Delilah's doing at Brigmore.
Why ask? When the change comes, you won't even notice. You'll never even know how we won. But when Delilah sits the secret throne, our reign will never end.
That's enough.
Gangs are at each other's throats. Dowd is mired here. You'll have the time you need. And the portrait of the girl, is it? Excuse me, my lady. You're right. I should not have asked.
Dowd. Lurk told me you wouldn't give up. Even as she knelt before me and gave me all your secrets. I know what you're doing, Dad. I know what that mark on your hand is. Just like the one on mine. I know everything you can do, and it won't matter. Four of us chosen, but history will only remember one. Delilah.
If they remember any of us.
whole place is gone.
It's done. But I don't think you'll see your men again.
User says a deal's a deal. The code is 669. All due respect, we've got a business to run here. I told the men to lay off you, but I wouldn't wear out my welcome. Tell your friend, Lizzie Stride, to watch her back. The Eels are lucky Geezer knows how to make a bargain. Fighting. Wonder how long that'll last.
I don't know who you are, but I don't want any trouble.
You must be Skinflint.
Yeah. Why?
You should pay your debts. Soon. I've been talking to Jerome.
I understand. You bet, mister. I'm gonna do that. Thanks for letting me slide on this.
You should get where you're going, little man.
How did it pass me by? All the others down with the sickness. I hope you're keeping my little job in mind.
Skinflint is dead.
Delightful. As agreed, your reward. The best Draper's Ward, all for sale.
We take on the Bottle Street boys next, maybe. Pick up a few more blocks of territory.
Just because we're not fighting the Hatters doesn't mean I trust them.
You're not seeing the opportunity here. We could wind up owning half this city.
Blood in the streets. Reminds me of the Bottle Street mess we got into once.
The geezer mentioned you before he died.
He's really gone?
What's it matter?
Nothing. He was just a cracked old man. Reattach that coil, and we'll start up river tonight. You are an only source of adventure, Dowd. Please, do the honors, Dowd. Fire up the engine from the bridge. Give us another way. I'm ready to put Coldridge far behind us.
Thank you.